Are you tired of seeing the same old GPU gaming benchmark videos? Well, get ready for something totally different. In today's video, we are going to take a closer look at how AMD's RX 7900 XTX GPU performs when it comes to content creation and video editing. We will analyze the latest Puget Bench Adobe Premiere Pro and Blender results and compare AMD RX 7900 XTX with NVIDIA's RTX 4090 and 4080. By the way, if you are interested in the specific hardware setup that was used to run all these tests, you can find more details in the video description below. Alright, let's talk about video editing and the importance of a powerful GPU for GPU accelerated effects like color grading, blurring, and noise reduction. In this department, RX 7900 XTX holds its own and performs on par with the top-end RTX 30 series cards and RTX 4080. But it falls behind RTX 4090, which comes out ahead by about 16%. Considering the price difference between RX 7900 XTX and RTX 4090, I think this performance gap is perfectly acceptable. Okay, now let's focus on the geometric mean of H.264 and HEVC encoding and decoding results. This test measures how good the hardware media encoders and decoders perform in a GPU. So when it comes to Adobe Premiere Pro video editing software, AMD's RX 7900 XTX really shines. It beats NVIDIA's RTX 4080 and 4090 by about 20% and comes out ahead of the previous generation RX 6900 XT by a whopping 60%. These are impressive gains and show that AMD RX 7900 XTX is a strong contender in video editing space. Next, let's take a closer look at debayering Red RAW performance. In my last video, I mentioned how RX 7900 XTX performed extremely well in this test while running DaVinci Resolve. However, for some strange reason, 7900 XTX fails to deliver the same performance in Adobe Premiere Pro. In fact, we see extremely poor performance, even lower than RX 6900 XT. This is strange and could potentially be due to some kind of driver or application bug that is negatively impacting these newer generation cards. It's definitely worth keeping an eye on this issue. Let's hope that AMD addresses it in their future driver updates or Adobe releases a patch. Next, let's take a look at the extended overall score from Puget Bench. Here we find RX 7900 XTX lagging behind RTX 4090 and 4080, but performing more in line with RTX 3080 and 3090. Now, it's important to note that this isn't a terrible showing by any means. After all, RX 7900 XTX is still beating the previous AMD flagship GPU by 22%, which is significant improvement. One thing that I find really interesting is that even though the RX 7900 XTX has more video RAM than RTX 4080, it still loses in the extended overall benchmark. This makes me wonder how much of an advantage the video RAM really offers in a GPU when it comes to content creation. To explore this further, let's take a closer look at the GPU rendering performance in Blender. Although a lot of GPU renderers don't support AMD cards, Blender is an exception. So in this test, RX 7900 XTX was able to outperform the RX 6900 XT and the 12GB model of RTX 2080 Ti. In fact, it showed about 70% improvement over the previous generation RX 6900 XT card, but it could not keep up with the rendering power of NVIDIA RTX GPUs. AMD RX 7900 XTX lagged behind all NVIDIA 30 series GPUs, and its performance was significantly lower than RTX 4080 and 4090. Historically, AMD has been a reliable choice for gaming, but it often lagged behind NVIDIA in content creation workspace. Although RX 7900 XTX delivers some improvements for AMD, it still struggles in a number of areas compared to NVIDIA GPUs. Its 24GB of video RAM is definitely a nice feature, but many of the tasks that benefit from high video RAM still perform better on NVIDIA GPUs. So overall, AMD's Radeon RX 7900 XTX did excel in few specific workloads. It did really well in handling H.264 and HEVC media codecs and managed to outperform all other NVIDIA GPUs. But in other areas, its performance was underwhelming. For example, when it comes to GPU rendering in Blender, RX 7900 XTX absolutely got trounced by NVIDIA RTX GPUs. These results highlight the significant performance gap between AMD and NVIDIA GPUs when it comes to professional workloads. NVIDIA has a clear advantage in terms of raw rendering power thanks to their advanced CUDA and RTX libraries. Because of this, I think Nvidia still offers the best GPU for content creators. The fact that RTX 4080 is almost 3 times faster for a relatively small price difference, I think most professionals would stick with Nvidia. But if you are a DaVinci Resolve user, the latest Puget Bench results will surprise you. So check out this video over here where I cover all the DaVinci Resolve benchmarks in detail. So go ahead and watch that video and I will see you guys over there. Bye.